So we are back for another day working on the GS300. Getting pretty excited, to be honest. Seeing the engine bay and primer, getting all the bodywork knocked out, really getting me excited to see the final product. I'm sure you guys are pretty excited too. Today we're gonna go ahead and prep the engine bay, prep the primer. We sprayed it yesterday, so today I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand it. I got some 600 grit, got some guide coat. So if some of you missed my last video, we got the engine bay and primer. As you can see, looks pretty good, pretty uniform. Got a little sagger right there because it was super cold, but we knocked out some bodywork right there. And right there, there were some massive holes that we patched up. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this guy off. All right, so got the engine bay all sanded down, 600 wet, and then a Scotch-Brite to get all the nooks and crannies. Not super worried about all this stuff right here. Those plates sit on top of there, and then the nuts for the coilovers go on top. So 600 grit wet, and then a Scotch-Brite, you know, got everything prepped up nice. Everything's super smooth. I do have some bare metal here, you know, just kind of throughout. So I'm going to have to put down either some etch primer or some sealer, some DTM. Basically what I sprayed for primer, I can spray it as a sealer. I just have to reduce it more. So not a big deal. It'll fill some more scratches and stuff like that. So in all honesty, that's even better. So stay tuned. Next clip you guys see, hopefully this thing is gonna be painted. I have to detape everything and rebag it just because this stuff is all nasty and I had to cut it up. What's going on, guys? Today is paint day. It's Sunday. Was hoping to do it yesterday, but didn't get to. Today's actually a nicer day anyway, so we're gonna get right into it. I gotta clean up my garage, clean up my mess, make some room, and we're gonna get right into things. We're gonna tape up the car, bag up the car. Hopefully we can spray this and have an awesome result. I already debagged the car. That's all good. I'm gonna retape it, redo everything because less dust, fresh product is always better. As you can see, I got a massive mess. So I'm gonna get on that and clean this up, and then we're gonna throw the time lapse on the car so I can go ahead and tape this up again, and we can start spraying some sealer right there, and start spraying some of that awesome base coat. All right, so I saved you guys the time of watching me tape this car up again. It is all bagged up. I got half the garage pretty much bagged up. And let me just give you guys one final look at the primered engine bay. And we're gonna get into mixing some sealer and then the base coat. Just a little look at what I did. I would do a second row, but I think it's gonna be enough. I'm just trying to get the smell and like the overspray off of everything that's over there. I do have a little fan set up that's going to be going out the window. I got my little electric heater right there, kind of trying to warm this place up. It's about 55 right now. I'll probably get it to 60 and then I'll start spraying. I'm gonna go ahead and clean everything up. I got some preps all in that squirter, so I'm gonna go ahead, wipe everything down, make sure it's nice and clean, go over it with a tack rag. I got a brand new tack rag over there too. After that, I'll set you guys up and you guys will watch me spray this thing. Pretty excited. I'm excited for the outcome and I think you guys will love the color. We'll be right back. All right, so it's about 7:30. We've been at this for about an hour. We got three coats of base on. It is time to spray the mid coat, the pearl, metallic, whatever. It's a tri-stage color. If you guys want to go ahead and guess right now, the color is going to be revealed in this video, but if you want to just, I don't know, throw it down in the comments if you guys want, but it is time to mix up the mid coat, and I'm so excited. So far, so good. Everything's looking pretty good. Everything is laying down nice. The base coat looks great. Good coverage. And so now let's slam out three coats of the mid coat, and then we get the clear coat. One last look before I go to clear. Everything's looking awesome. Let's go ahead and mix up some matrix clear. First coat of clear, guys, looking pretty damn good. Hell yeah. We're gonna do two, so one more. Well, guys, we're all done spraying. Oh, almost knocked over a little pieces right there. We're all done spraying. This in total took about, I don't know, 2 hours, maybe a bit more. Between the weather, getting everything ready, cleaning up the garage a bit, took a little bit longer than I wanted to. The tri-coat paint, you know, takes a bit longer. Anything with paint always takes a long time. You always think it's gonna be an hour, multiply that by two automatically. But I am absolutely astonished by this paint. I will link this paint down in the description if one of you guys want to buy this and spray it yourself. For a little garage job, I think this came out great. This just shows you guys can do this yourself. I did use a Iwata spray gun, so it's on the higher end. It's pretty good. It's about $300-$400, but you can get these results with pretty much any gun as long as you lay it down correctly and use the gun correctly. But let me go ahead, flip the camera around, and show you guys the finished product.
Ryan Little.
All I can say is I'm absolutely blown away by how good this turned out. Being a shop or a garage job, you know, it's got a little bit of dust in it, nothing crazy. You know, if I really want to, I'll go ahead and denib a couple spots here and there, but it is an engine bay. The car is not 100%. It's an engine bay. You know what I mean? It's going to get dirty. I was not shooting for perfection. I was shooting for good enough. And I think we definitely accomplished that. Let me know if you guys want to see the valve cover this color, or the coil pack cover. I currently have it paint matched. The white with this color might look a little weird in the engine bay. I was thinking maybe to polish the valve covers and then have the coil pack cover be the same color as the engine bay. So I think that'd look pretty good. It would match the compressor side on the turbo. But yeah, I'm stoked. This is awesome. I can't wait to put this thing back together and just go for a drive. If you guys like what you see, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. Throw me a comment. Tell me if you like it. Tell me if you hate it. Tell me what you want to see. Tell me what you want to see more of. Go ahead and drop it sub. If you guys are into the GS300 content, if you guys are into future Skyline content, I'm going to be painting my GTR very, very soon. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you in the next one. Before I end this video, I rolled the car out. It's the next day. The sun's obviously in the wrong spot, but this paint is just crazy. Look at this. You just see it change. Hell yeah.